We are here to celebrate the 3 decades of the service of the Global Hospital and Research Center. Global Hospital and Research Center Trust was established in 1989. The main hospital started in 91, and then subsequently we started with a rural center, then eye hospital, trauma center, nursing college, old age home, and then also we were offered a public-private partnership in hospital in Mumbai. So the story has been very amazing, how we started with a small service center at Mount Abu, which has now grown into 100-bedded hospital. And from the day one, it has been a hospital without walls, that we have been touring to the villages. It's a community hospital where we travel to the villages, offer them the services. And sometimes even the van goes and picks up the patient who require hospitalization. So it has been a hospital which is for the common people, for the poor people, for the tribal people of this area. The day when we started, we had it in our mind that this is a hospital which is supported by Brahma Kumaris. Brahma Kumaris worldwide teach meditation and values. So it's a hospital which is a holistic hospital. It's a hospital which is environment friendly. We had to modify our design to save some trees. And today we have solar system to heat water. We have solar steam generations. We also recycle our water, we generate biogas, and today we also generate power through the solar system. We have been emphasizing that lifestyle changes, vegetarian diet, regular exercise, good sleep, and stress management, they can all fasten the recovery and also reduce the need of medication. Particularly our coronary artery disease regression program, which was started by Dr. Satish Gupta, it has documented that if stress can worsen the disease, the meditation or positive thinking or a healthy lifestyle can reverse it also. So likewise, we have also documented the diabetic patients can benefit from a holistic lifestyle, and even people who are hooked on to drugs, they can also benefit. In 3 decades of service, we have been able to provide specialized service also. I would say this is the only hospital, private hospital in the private sector, which has a regional blood bank. We have almost 5,000 to 6,000 voluntary donations, and our voluntary donation rate is almost to the 99%. And over the years, we have won prizes with the state government for voluntary blood donation. Today, we offer to the whole area the components. Also have a very specialized CT scan where we can do CT angios and all other specialized investigation. So it's a way we have tried to blend meditation with technology, and this is a hospital which is kind of a research, training, education, everything is there. We are a recognized research center by the Ministry of Science and Technology. We have been recognized as a teaching hospital by the National Board for Examination. Recognized by the Indian Nursing Council for Nursing Education. Foundation is not only helping patients, but also training manpower, educating people, and having continuous medical education to come to international standards of care. Specialized care for children, like we have reconstructive surgeries for children, also pediatric orthopedics, pediatric ophthalmologies, wherein we offer to the children of all ages the eye care, the orthopedics, correcting the deformities, and also cleft lip and cleft palate surgeries, which are supported by Smile Train. We have been doing it for almost now last 15 years, and we must have helped almost about to the tune of 2,000 to 3,000 children. And it's a holistic program in the sense that as the child grows, the skills are provided to him, speech therapy is provided to him, orthodontics is provided to him, dental care, ENT care. So we are a recognized center for training here for any Smile Train accredited surgeons to come and learn here. Does collaborate with national and international organizations, various NGOs, like we have been supported by Janki Foundation, which is a foundation started in the name of Dadi Janki, and they have come out with an innovative program of values in healthcare, a spiritual approach, particularly looking after the healthcare professionals. We feel that the doctors and the nurses who are working in the healthcare area, they also need support, they also need counseling, they also need to be looked after emotionally. So that's what we have been doing for several years. The Vyasa is now spread over all over the country. Supported by national and international organizations to do innovative programs, bring newness our care program. One of the first was Smile Train, wherein we started doing reconstructive surgeries for children. Then was the Orbis. Orbis has been supporting us for pediatric ophthalmology. We not only trained our doctors and nurses, but we also trained school teachers to screen children. We went to schools and taught the teachers how to screen visual impairment. The purpose is to reach to the children at early age. So these are their productive years. We have been doing this program for several years. And we have also done this for Government of Rajasthan in screening all the schools of the Western Rajasthan. Visiting orthopedic surgeon who trained in pediatrics to look after the deformity of the children so that the children are helped at the early age, particularly deformities and mobility which need attention. And we are a teaching hospital because we have been accredited by the national board to run a fellowship program, the 3 years diplomate of the national board in family medicine and also ophthalmology. So all this has been possible by our friends across the world. We have been supported by a Dutch trust which has been regularly supporting us, as I said, in alternative energy, in nursing education. And then we have Point of Life in America, which has been supporting our work for several years. Particularly in this COVID-19, they have supported us to run the hospital in the operational part of the hospital, and also buying equipment for the COVID-19 support care. So our staff has been very proactive in the sense that we have reached out to the surrounding areas and helped the government in screening for coronavirus affected patients and also for management and quarantine of these patients. So it has been in a kind of a collaborative projects. We have supported them, some schools in nutrition program, in education, because our mandate is both health and education. So that's what we have been focusing on all these years. The growth, what we see in the today, we started with 10 beds, and today we have almost, I would say, 250 beds, all collectively. So they all amount to taking care of this area. And plus, we started with just 30 people, and today we are almost 1,000 people working in the healthcare area. So this has been a collective team effort, an effort which has been supported by values, which has been blended by meditation, and we have been able to bring out a model which people visit, they learn, we enjoy sharing our experience with them. Vision is to provide the international standards of care at affordable cost, and we feel that this has been possible just because of the support and the training which we have received. And we also feel that we need to develop our services in the field of neurosurgery, in the field of urology and nephrology in the coming years. Neurosurgery is one area. Because of the being proximity to the national highways, a lot of injury, polytrauma patients come. At the moment, at our trauma center, we have a full-time orthopedic surgeon and general surgeon. But what we lack is the facility to do neurosurgery. So in the coming years, we would like to develop that. And at the Mount Abu Hospital, we would like to develop more of nephrology, more of dialysis, these facilities with specialized care, and even go forward to renal transplant. And we also feel that we need to augment our use of our meditation and positive thinking for the benefit of the patients and their relatives, so that we not only take care of their illnesses but also teach them what is the promotion of health, what is the prevention of the diseases, how with meditation, vegetarian diet, exercise and good sleep and good stress management, they can lead a normal and healthy life. Not only healthy, but also a life which is full of quality, which is full of happiness, and which is full of carefree living.